saw this, but he's got a great leap on him.
Over on the edge of the area. Again, it will be John Long to take it. Encouragement for the Grimsby supporters. Arnold came through and he didn't get to it. And there's the opening goal. It's Omar Bogle who celebrates. The hero of the semi-final has done it again for Grimsby Town. Real crowd of bodies inside the penalty area. Bogle making his presence felt, but after just being the hero, was Arnold at fault here.
Talking about dropping deep into the box, the keeper comes and he doesn't get there. If you come all that way, you've got to come and punch it and make a decision. Bogle, like he did against Braintree, was brave in the area. But it just comes off the back of Darren Carter's head. But he certainly will be claiming that. I'll be looking at the goalkeeper. When you made that decision to come, you have to go all the way and punch.
Split to Grimsby. And now the supporters want them to press home their advantage. Lofted forward here towards Doric Hammond. Grimsby on the charge. Nolan. The wind in their sails. Robertson with the cross. Too high for Bogle. Driven in. That's built. And Bogle. Again. Two quick fire goals for Grimsby Town. Our 6 years of hurt about to end for the Mariners. Sheer joy for the travelling Grimsby supporters. Paul Hurst's side, as it stands, are finally heading back to the Football League.
Well, this game is just literally turned on its head in a couple of minutes. And it's a sign of a quality striker. He's always looking for seconds, he doesn't get it there, but he's always alive. Arnold does brilliantly on the edge of the box to win it. Pulls a save out of Steve Arnold, and there you are. Bogle alive, getting that second ball. We saw earlier James McEwen, when he parried his, the defender got there to clear it. And then on this occasion, Bogle is first one there, and it's really given Paul's Hurst side an important lead going into half-time.
Well, he wasn't at the club last season, Omar Bogle. He didn't experience that Wembley heartache. Signed from Solihull Moors last summer.